Okay, so good afternoon everyone. So today I will be discussing about the netiquette of the online classes. Okay, this topic is very important because we are now in the new normal of this because of this pandemic. So by the way, I am Ramon Pitao. I am a licensed mechanical engineer. And I am also a chairperson for the mechanical engineering here in BIPSU, Biliran Province State University. So a member of BIPSU since November 3, 2016. So after my board exam, after passing the board exam, and a month after I graduated from the BSME in WSSU, I already employed here as an educator. So since 2016, more than 3 years and almost 4 years, and a researcher, 2 international publications, and utility model registered in the IPOFIL, Intellectual Property Office of the Philippines. So an industry practitioner. So I am also as an engineer, I am also practicing my field as an engineer. So I practice project or project monitoring, project supervision, and in my vacant time. So sometimes pag may vacant ako, so I will practice this as an engineer in the field, not in an educator, so that we know what are the actual application of the engineers. So that's it. So we'll discuss now the topic proper. So again, our topic today is online netiquette. Okay, mga netiquettes na kailangan natin tandaan during online classes. This is very important topic because sometimes hindi natin napapansin, so medyo may nalalabag na pala tayo, may nagagawa na pala tayo, may nasasabi na pala tayo sa internet na side or sa online na side na hindi pala tama. Okay? So online netiquette. So as we enter into the new normal, of course, education kailangan natin magpatuloy. So hindi pwede na mag-stop yung education. Even may pandemic o wala, hindi pwede mag-stop ang education. In fact, education is not only in the classroom, not only in the university. Okay? But it is also but we also educate in our house. We educate our friends, we educate from our mentor, parents. So, marami tayong nakukuha o pakikisama natin sa ibang tao. So internet online classes, online submission of requirements. So ito yung mga i-consider natin, yung mga netiquettes ng internet sa online classes, online submission of requirements. So will also be a new normal. So new normal na kasi. It is important that we become aware of the digital do's and don'ts. So, ito yung tandaan natin yung mga do's and don'ts dito sa netiquette. Just like how we are reminded of etiquettes and ethics during our face-to-face. Sometimes, di ba, sa wala pang, hindi pa tayo nag-online classes. So, yung mga etiquette na ginagawa natin, ganun din yun. But, take note plus that in the new normal or sa internet na side, mas important more ang ating i-apply na mga ethics at mga etiquettes na mga practices. So we have also to bear in mind that different etiquettes while we are in online. So that's why yan ang sinasabi niya. So, thus we need to know about different online etiquettes. Okay, what are netiquettes? So from the definition of netiquettes, so according to this article, so netiquette is a combination of terms net and etiquette. So netiquette, which refers to the set of informal and unwritten guidelines. So, net and etiquette refers to the informal and unwritten guidelines. So, bakit may informal and unwritten guidelines? Okay, so we will continue and set rules for the acceptable online behavior. So, because may informal na nasasabi tayo, may mga nasasabi tayo na informal and unwritten guidelines. Like for example, may mga mag-blog-blog tayo. So, may sometimes hindi tayo magandang guidelines dyan na nalalagay. So, be careful of those mga videos na i-upload natin sa internet. So, according to Miller in 2001, published in 2000, defines it as a blended of common sense. So, this is the very hint, okay? So, very direct definition or very direct clue what is netiquette. So, blend of common sense, common courtesy, and dictates of the computer technology and culture established by internet users. Okay? Take note na blended of common sense. So, common sense always. Okay? Top priority ang common sense pag nakaharap nyo na yung computer, cell phones with internet connections. Okay? Kasi konting pagkakamali, ma-upload mo yan. So, ang very... The problem of the internet than the actual classes or the face-to-face is yung mahirap kasi sa internet is yung population mo, feeling mo ay ikaw lang mag-isa, dalawa lang kayo, tatlo lang kayo sa isang kwarto mo during classes or nasa park kayo, nagka-classes, nakatingin ka lang sa cellphone, hindi mo alam na you are very crowded. So, mas crowded pa doon sa actual classroom. Let's say, for example, may classmate ka sa classroom na 34, so 39 lang, 33 lang yung pwedeng makarinig sa'yo. Like, for example, may classmate ka na 7, 6 lang ang makakarinig sa'yo. Or, kasaling yung teacher, so konti lang. Unlike sa internet, is feeling mo ikaw lang mag-isa nakaharap, but you are online. Pag may na-upload, pag may na-message ka dyan na hindi maganda at nagpasapasan na, nag-forward na, hindi mo na yan madaling agapan. Okay? That's why very broad ang or mas crowded yung internet. Feeling lang natin na hindi tayo crowded kasi mag-isa lang tayo. Pero pag nilabas natin sa online, kahit sa ibang bansa, aabot yung mga thoughts mo, yung mga hindi magandang na-upload mo. Okay? So, very careful. That's why always use your common sense. Okay? These are the adaptations of real-life etiquettes and norms of behavior that we practiced online. Okay? Because not all naman na student, not all naman na person is hindi maingat sa online, but may background na dun dito sa netiquettes, so aware naman sila. That's why be careful always. Like for example, yung mga fake news, so kahit sa social media pa yan, hindi mo dapat sinishare palagi, hindi mo kaagad sinishare because of those sources na not reliable. Okay? So, dito naman sa online classes, that's why may, sa baba mamaya, may mga important na reminders or mga dapat i-consider natin during classes, during submission, so during lahat ng mga gawain dito sa online classes. Okay? In the 1990s, so the term netiquette was coined to describe the protocol, so guidelines for proper behavior. Okay, so if you relate the netiquette, that is the, according to 1990s, na middle 1990s, that is the guidelines for proper behavior. So, guidelines for proper behavior, ito, so susulatan natin ah. So, guidelines for proper behavior and then blended of common sense. Okay, pag sinama mo yan, okay na. So, di ba? Use your common sense. Pag ginamit mo yung your common sense, then i-consider mo ngayon yung mga guidelines for proper behavior. Of course naman, alam naman natin kung ano yung good behavior, di ba? So, pag sinama mo yan ng common sense, medyo okay na yung kalalabasan, okay? So, especially, dito yan ginagamit yung guidelines, dito yan ginagamit, mag-send ka ng email, internet chat rooms, mga electronic bulletin boards. So, ngayon, may ginagamit tayo na BIPSU LMS or Learning Management System dito, may chat box doon. So, of course, use your netiquettes na mga tamang netiquettes yung gamitin doon. Okay? So, because mas madali kasi mag-spread yung words, mas lalo na pag bad words, mas maganda, mas madali mag-spread sa during online. Why are online tickets is important? So, this is very maganda to. So, bakit daw? Tingnan natin. So, what you are online will define what you are offline. So, this is only a phrase, ha? So, this is kung ano daw yung kung ano ka daw sa online, dun din yung pagkakilala sa offline. So nasabi lang ito ni Fries nung ni-publish niya ng 2004, because 'di ba, if for example may chatmate ka, o oh, mga chatmate. So may mga chatmate ka hindi mo kilala, taga Mindanao ngayon, ikaw taga Leyte. And then chatmate mo pa lang, hindi mo pa nakita personal, pero may naggamit pala siya ng mga picture ni Fiolo Pascual. Wow, Fiolo Pascual. Gamit siya ng mga picture niya, then yung mga chat niya ay maganda, mabait. So, yun na yung pagkakilala mo. Sasabihin mo ngayon, napakabait ni kuya. Okay? So, napakabait ni ate. Maganda pa, magwapo pa. So, meaning to say, kung ano yung nakikilala mo siya, kung ano yung pagkakilala mo sa kanya during online, because online is nakachat mo lang eh, malayo eh. So, in-anticipate mo, in-assume mo na, ganun siya pag offline, meaning yung pag mag-meet na kayo, okay? Pag mag-meet na kayo, ganun yun ha? Okay, so, online behavior and our practice of ethics in the internet reflects how we deal with people, of course. Diba? So, mag-reflect yan. Whether hindi kayon ganun, na ganun, na gamit mo lang yung ganun yung pagkatao mo because of the internet, kahit sa personal hindi ka ganun, yung pagkilala sa tao, yung pagkilala ng tao sa iyo is, that is your reflection. So, that's why online behavior and our practice of ethics in the internet reflects how we deal with people, okay? So, this is why we have to be extra careful, of course, with how we respond, interact, and use the website or the web. So, during online, okay? Yan yung very important. Etiquette online is not just nice to have. So, hindi lang magandang magkaroon ng etiquette, but it is necessary.